Welcome to our Christmas reflection on Boxing Day, the 26th of December, 2023. Today we meet the shepherds out on the hills above Bethlehem in the quiet of the night, minding their sheep.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
We hear the story of the angels appearing to the shepherds every year. But how often do we stop and really think what an amazing night those shepherds had? There they are, minding their own business and their sheep, when suddenly an angel appears. Not your average evening's entertainment. And while they are struggling with the shock of that, they hear an incredible message about a special baby, the Saviour, who has been born down in the town below. And then more angels appear, singing praise to God. Wow! They might have carried on as before when the angels left, but these lowly men don't. They decide to act on the message of the angels and go and see for themselves. And when they have met the baby, they don't keep it to themselves. They spread the word, the first evangelists. And we can only assume from this that meeting the baby Jesus changed their lives. There is a lovely story by Michael Morpurgo called On Angel Wings, which tells the story of the shepherds from the perspective of the youngest boy, who's left behind to look after the sheep while the others go off to Bethlehem. The angel Gabriel offers to take him to Jesus while the other angels look after the sheep for him. The angel carries him as he flies, and he gets to the stable before the others. Listen to this short excerpt from the story. In the dim light of the stable, I could see several oxen chewing their cud, grunting contentedly. One of them licked deep into her nose as I passed by. I could still see no baby, no Christ child, no king. I was beginning to wonder if the angel had brought me to the wrong place. Then, from a stall at the far end of the stable, came a man's voice. "We're over here," he said, "where the sheep are. Careful you don't tread on them." The sheep shifted as I walked slowly through them. A lamb came skittering out of the shadows and suckled his mother furiously, his tail waggling with wild delight. It was then I saw them, at last, their faces bright in the lamplight. Come closer, said Mary. You won't be disturbing him. He's wide awake. She was sitting propped up in the hay, the baby cradled in her arms. All I could see of him was a pink face and one tiny hand, which he waved a little and then promptly shoved in his mouth. He was looking at me, straight at me, and when at last he took his fist out of his mouth, he smiled. And it was a smile I have never forgotten, a smile of such love that it moves my heart to this day whenever I think of it. I crouched down in the straw beside them, and when I offered him my finger, he clung onto it and didn't seem to want to let go. He's strong, I said. He'll need to be, said Joseph. We talked in whispers, the three of us, and Joseph told me how ashamed he was not to have found a better place for Mary to give birth, but that everywhere in Bethlehem all the inns were full. It's fine, said Mary. It's warm in here, and his manger's full of soft hay for a cradle. He has all he needs, and now he has his first visitor. Would you like to hold him for a while? I'd never in all my life held a baby before. Plenty of lambs, but never a baby. Joseph showed me how to do it. Babies were easier, I discovered. They didn't wriggle so much. What's he called? I asked, cradling him in my arms, hoping against hope he wouldn't cry. Jesus, Mary said. We're calling him Jesus. So for a few precious minutes, I held him in my arms, the child that has been the light of my life ever since. I stayed until they laid him in his manger of hay, until he fell asleep, and Mary too. Then Joseph took me back through the sheep to the stable door to say goodbye. There may be more visitors tonight, said Joseph, but you were the first. We shan't forget you. Nor I you, I replied. I love the phrase, I held him in my arms, the child that has been the light of my life ever since. Meeting Jesus personally changes our lives. In meeting Jesus, we see the light of his love, and that love lives in us. As we nurture it by building our relationship with him, our lives too change for the better. We understand more about God's amazing gift of love in Jesus, and we can never be the same again. So, as we ponder on the night those shepherds had, let us ask God to fill us afresh with wonder and with his love, that he may continue to change our lives into those, by his grace, he calls us to live, spreading the good news of the baby born to save us by his love and bringing peace to the world. Lord God, let us be like the shepherds who heard your message and acted on it, finding and meeting Jesus, your Son, the light of the world and the good shepherd. People whose lives were changed by being in the presence of the newborn Saviour of the world. Fill us afresh with the light of your love. May we marvel at your gift of love. Change us, mould us, and through us shine your light to the world. In a moment of quiet, we bring to God those on our hearts and in our minds who need a touch of God's light, love, peace and healing at this time. Thank you, God. Amen. And we close with one of my favourite Christmas carols, It Was on a Starry Night. The second verse is about the changed lives of the shepherds in their encounter with the King of all the world.